So just in this time, I just pray that it will be our prayer and to truly just answer to that calling, to come as we are. So.
It makes no sense, but this is grace. And if this is not true, you don't have to sing it, but you know, ask God, you know, is this where I want my heart to be like?
Yes.
So I think Myrna forgot to introduce. We have Dr. Naziuh Bishai all the way from Asyut coming to share the word with us. Funny, this reminds me of a story I read about giving God the glory. And so there was a really humble pastor that walked up to the podium, and then people started clapping. And so he stepped to the side and started, but he was doing it sincerely. He started clapping because he thought it was for someone else. And it reminds me a lot of Naziuh's humility. He has the humility of God. He humbles himself before God.
حقيقة أنا يعني حاولت مع وديع إن هو يكمل الرسالة بتاعته بتاعت اللي بدأ بيها كان نفسي هو اللي يكمل لأنه ما تعرفوش قد إيه أنا يعني اتباركت في الاجتماع كل مرة كان بيتكلم فيها
Naziuh is a blessing.
You know, I can speak English here. All right. Sahin?
You guys awake?
All right. Johnny, are you awake? All right. Yeah, let us. نعمل تدريبات مش مصارعة يعني بس تدريبات.
Okay. We're going to do stretching and exercises, not wrestling ones, but.
All right. خلينا ناخد يعني الحياة يعني وديع أخد قلب الموضوع.
And so we studied the heart of the problem of the topic.
وأنا باخد ال يعني ال الحاجات اللي قبليها واللي بعديها.
And I'm covering the things that connected together.
فوديع اتكلم في يعقوب 4 من عدد 4 لغاية 10 وأنا بتكلم من 1 تكلمنا من 1 ل 3 وهنتكلم من 11 للآخر.
So we just covered from 4 to 10 and in the first message of Naziuh he covered from 1 through 4 and then now he's going to take from 11 to 10.
وكله متجمع مع بعض كله مرتبط ببعض.
It all actually connects together and ties together.
الكتاب كله نافع للتعليم.
The entire Bible is very beneficial for teaching.
وما فيش حاجة بتتقال كده يعني قبل أو بعد بدون سبب.
And nothing is said before or after without a reason.
فاحنا عرفنا الصبح إن سبب ده الأسد اللي جوايا.
See? So this is the lion that's inside.
ده الأسد الطبيعي الطفل يعني اللي بيعبر.
It's a child that expressing like a lion.
لكن كل واحد فينا في قلب زي نيثن كده.
But all of us have a hidden heart like Nathan, a child's heart.
لما بنكبر بنحاول إن احنا نخفي الطفولة بتاعتنا.
A lot of times when we grow older, we try to hide our childhoodness.
لكن everybody has Nathan's screaming. مصمم إن هو يلاقي التايجر يعني.
He's insisting to find the tiger.
وماسك عصا هي.
And he has a stick.
He wanted to hit that tiger. I'm serious. He cannot sleep since morning. He's trying to find the tiger. And he is carrying the stick and say, "Ow!" Oh, he's training. I mean, practicing how he's going to hit the tiger and kill him. And so anyway. صحح أربعة لقينا من أين الحبوب والمخاصمات and so بينكم.
We've seen in chapter 4 where he starts off by saying, where do wars and fights come from
سؤال.
Among you? It's a question mark.
سؤال لينا نجاوب عليه.
And it's a question for us to answer.
العجيب ان الاصحاح اللي قبليه بيختم بالسلام.
The strange thing is the chapter before it ends with peace.
أصحاح ثلاثة.
That's chapter 3.
بيتكلم بيقول وثمر البر يزرع في السلام الذين يفعلون السلام.
It says now the fruit of righteousness is sown in peace by those who make peace.
وكان بيتكلم عن الحكمة اللي نازلة من الفوق.
He's speaking about wisdom that comes from above.
حكمة فيها سلام.
Peace, wisdom that has peace.
لكن حكمة الإنسانية النفسانية الشيطانية.
But the human and demonic and personal wisdom.
فيها غيرة وتحزب في القلب.
There's envy and self-seeking.
بيقول الحكمة دي مش نازلة من فوق اللي بتعمل تشويش وبتعمل تحزبات في الكنيسة.
And so this type of wisdom that causes divisions in the church and causes a noise is not from God.
بل هي نفسية وشيطانية.
But it is demonic and it is self-seeking.
لأن حيث الغيرة أول ما نلاقي في غيرة.
Because
تحزب,
whenever you find their envy,
هناك تشويش.
There's disruption.
وكل أمر بديء من إبليس.
And everything evil from Satan.
لكن الحكمة اللي من فوق.
But the wisdom that's from above.
فهي طاهرة.
It is pure.
مسالمة.
Peaceable.
مترفقة.
Gentle.
مزينة.
Willing to yield.
مملوء رحمة.
Full of mercy.
أثمار صالحة عديمة الريب والرياء.
Good fruits without partiality and without hypocrisy. Now the fruit of righteousness is sown in peace by those who make
اختبر
peace.
الحكمة اللي جاية لك دي حكمة شيطانية نفسانية ولا حكمة نازلة من فوق.
Examine the wisdom that's coming to you. Is it demonic? Is it earthly? Or is it coming from above?
لو الأفكار اللي جاية ليك علشان بتقول لك اعمل حاجة فيها تحزب وفيها تشويش وفيها انقسامات اعرف ان هي حكمة مش من ربنا.
Whatever your thoughts are telling you to do, if they will cause divisions, disruption and noise, you need to know that's from Satan, not from God.
الحكمة اللي نازلة من السماء.
Because the wisdom that comes from heaven
هي طاهرة ومسالمة.
Pure is pure and peaceable.
مترفقة.
Is gentle.
مملوءة رحمة.
Full of mercy.
وثمر البر يزرع في السلام وفيها سلام.
And the fruit of righteousness is sown in peace and there's peace there.
بعدها على طول يقول لنا في حرب.
And right after that he says there's warfare. There's fights and wars.
وبيسأل الحرب دي بتيجي من فين؟
And he's asking what's the source? Where does this come from? This war.
عرفنا الصبح جاية من فين؟
And we found out in the morning where's it coming from?
مش جاية من اختلافات الرأي لأن في اختلافات رأي ما تعملش حروب وما تعملش انزعاجات.
It is not because we have differences of opinion because we already have that and that is not enough to cause wars and fights.
الكتاب مش بيقول إن war علشان إحنا مختلفين في الأفكار لا.
It doesn't say that we have wars because we have difference in opinions and thoughts.
ممكن يكون ليك رأي يختلف عن رأيي.
Maybe your opinion is different than mine.
كل واحد بيحترم التاني.
But we respect each other.
مفيش مشكلة.
It's not a problem.
واخدين بالكم؟
Do you get it?
يعني مش لازم نتفق كلنا نبقى رأي واحد يعني كلنا عندنا لا ممكن نختلف في الآراء.
We don't all have to agree on everything. It's okay.
كلنا شخصياتنا مختلفة.
We all have different personalities.
مش هو ده اللي بيتكلم عنه الكتاب هنا.
And that's not what the Bible is speaking about here.
يعني بولس مثلا وبرنابا كان كل واحد ليه رأي.
And so for example Paul and Barnabas they each had their own opinion.
يعني كان في واحد اسمه مرقس وبولس بيقول ما ينفعش وبرنابا بيقول لا ينفع لكن ما تخنقوش مع بعض.
And so you know you had a difference in opinion between Paul and Barnabas.
يعني ما حصلش انقسام في الكنيسة بسبب اختلاف الآراء.
Even though there was a difference in opinion, but there was no division.
لكن الحروب والمخاصمات بتيجي بسبب حاجة واحدة بس.
But the wars and the fights they come from one thing.
بسبب ال desires بتاعتنا.
It's because of our own desires.
وال desires الرغبات بتاعتنا أنا عشان بس يعني أوضح اللي قلت الصبح.
And just to clarify what I said in the morning about
ممكن
desires.
أكون يعني شوية يعني شوية تقيل على قلبك والصبح يعني.
Maybe I was heavy on you in the morning.
لأن كلنا عندنا رغبات.
Because we all have desires.
مفيش مشكلة في الرغبات اللي فينا، ربنا حط فينا رغبات.
There's nothing wrong with desires. God has given us desires.
لكن الرغبات اللي بتسود علينا وبتخلينا عبد للرغبات دي هي دي المشكلة.
But the problem happens and comes when a desire takes over us and becomes in control of us and we become a slave to it.
فأي لذة بتسيطر عليك وانت بتبقى عبد ليها.
And so any desire that takes control of you and you become a slave to it,
هي دي ممكن تعمل مشاكل.
This is what can cause problems.
وده اللي بيتكلم عنها الكتاب.
And this is what the Bible speaks about.
محتاجين ان احنا نروح لربنا ونقول له يا رب خد كنترول انت على الديزايرز دي.
We need to go to God and say, Lord, you take control of these desires.
محتاجين مساعدتك يا رب.
We want your help.
محتاجين نعمة.
We need grace.
علشان تمتلك الديزايرز بتاعتنا.
So that you would take control of our desires.
تاني حاجة عشان نختبر الديزايرز بتاعتنا دي يعني متفقة مع ربنا ولا لا مع إرادة ربنا.
And the second thing is we need to test these desires. Are they in line with God or not?
لأن لو ما كانتش يعني حسب مشيئة ربنا هتعمل مشاكل برضه.
Because if it's not according to God's will, it will cause problems as well.
عشان كده الكتاب بيقول تلذذ بالرب إلهك فيعطيك سؤل قلبك.
That's why the Bible says, "Delight in the Lord your God, and He will give you the desires of your heart."
The desires اللي بتاعت الهارت ربنا هيديها لك لما تكون في محضر وتتلذذ بالرب، فالرب يسيطر على الديزايرز دي ويديها لك لأنها بتبقى حسب مشيئة ربنا.
So when you delight in the Lord and you spend time in the Lord, He starts giving you those good desires and He starts satisfying those desires.
خلينا نختبر الرغبات بتاعتنا قدام في محضر ربنا.
Let's examine our desires in the presence of God.
ودايما نختبرها ونقول له يا رب اختبرني واعرف قلبي زي ما نمنع.
And let's always test it as we sang in the song. Let's say, test me, Lord. Examine me, Lord, and know my heart.
لأن القلب أخدع من كل شيء وهو نجيس زي ما عرفنا.
Because the heart, as we know, is more deceptive than everything.
ممكن أكون واخد صورة أو فكرة أو مقتنع إن الأمر بتاعي اللي أنا ماشي فيه صح ويكون غلط.
I could be completely convinced of something that I think is correct and it may be incorrect.
لأن الرب هو بس اللي يعرف القلوب.
But only God knows the hearts.
في آية في لوقا 16 خلينا نروح لوقا 16.
There's a verse in Luke 16. Let's go there.
ربنا يعرف القلب ويعرف اتجاهات القلب.
God knows the heart and the direction.
ما نقدرش نخدعه بالكلام.
We can't deceive him with words.
لأن الكلام بتاعنا ممكن حتى في محضر ربنا وفي الترنيم ممكن يكون مش صادق.
And our words, as that we speak before God, and sometimes that we sing, sometimes is not sincere.
احنا محتاجين لما نروح لربنا قول يا رب اختبر الكلام بتاعي حتى.
We need to even as we speak with the Lord, we need to ask the Lord to examine even what we're saying.
الفريسيين من الناس اللي هم كانوا متدينين جدا.
The Pharisees were quite religious people.
لكن كانوا بعاد قوي عن ربنا.
Yet they were so far from God.
عدد 14.
In verse 14.
الرب كان بيتكلم عن المال.
God was speaking. The Lord was speaking about money.
ودوا مس يعني قلوبهم لأنهم هم بيحبوا المال.
And this touched a sensitive topic with them because they loved money.
لكن الموضوع دوا كان طبعا ما يقولوش إحنا بنحب المال.
But they would never claim that they love money.
واحنا دايما الحاجات المخفية مش بنقولها.
And many times the hidden things we don't want to share them.
بنحاول نخبيها.
Try to hide them.
لكن ربنا شايف.
But God sees.
عشان كده الفريسيين لما كانوا سمعوا كلام عن المال.
And that's why the Pharisees when they heard the word about
وهم
money.
كانوا محبون للمال.
And these guys used to love money.
ابتدوا يستهزئوا بالمسيح.
They started to make fun, to mock Christ.
ما فيش حاجة كانت غلط في كلام المسيح.
There's nothing wrong in what Christ said.
الغلط كان فين؟
Where was the problem?
كان فيهم هم.
It was their issue. They had
لأن
the
هم كانوا بيحبوا المال.
Because they loved money.
وعظ الرب كان ليهم عن محبة المال.
And the message that Jesus was preaching was about love for money.
فالوعظة لما ما تعجبكش لأنها مست الحتة الضعيفة فيك.
And when a message, when we don't like it because it touches that weak part in us,
تبدأ تهاجم اللي بيتكلم.
We start attacking the speaker.
ويا حرام الناس اللي بتتكلم دي.
And all these poor speakers, I feel bad for them.
حرام.
These poor speakers.
أكتر ناس مظلومين في الدنيا.
They are the most people that are treated unfairly.
ولا صدقوني يعني. أنا بخاف أقف هنا ومش عايز أقف هنا عشان الموضوع مش عشان يعني لكن anyway.
And I fear standing here, and I don't want to stand here.
استهزأوا بالمسيح نفسه، فأنا استهزأوا بيا طبعاً أنا أروح لفين يعني، فماشي الحال. فكانوا محبون للمال فاستهزأوا به بالمسيح.
So they were mocking Christ. So you guys, I mean, obviously I'm not Christ, so you can make fun of me, but they were mocking Christ here.
ربنا على طول طبعاً شايف القلوب.
Obviously, the Lord Jesus, he sees right straight through the heart.
ما يتعبش أبدا بالاستهزاء بتاع الناس.
It doesn't really bother him for someone.
ولا يخليه يعني يغير رأيه في الأمور علشان الناس بتستهزأ بيه يعني.
And it does not even touch him or faze him to make him change his opinion because people are mocking him.
يا ترى أنا وأنت بنغير آرائنا واتجاهاتنا علشان نرضي الناس.
How about you and I? Do we change our opinions so we can please people?
لما أصحابك يستهزئوا بيك علشان أنت ماشي كويس أو ما عندكش boyfriend ولا girlfriend وبتدوا يضحكوا عليك.
Well, what do? You know, when your friends start making fun of you or mocking you, maybe you don't have a boyfriend or a girlfriend. What do?
تروح تجيب girlfriend عشان تبقى راجل يعني كده يعني.
Do you go get a girlfriend just to be a man, you know?
ولا تعملي قصة إن أنت معاكي boyfriend تعملي قصة يعني في خيالك يعني.
Or you
صدقوني بسمع الناس كده.
Imagine and make up a story of having a boyfriend. I hear
عشان بس تخلي الناس ما تستهزئش بيها فتقول oh yeah I have a boyfriend وتحمل قصة كبيرة والبنات حلوين قوي إنهم يعملوا قصص يعني كده.
And she'll say that yeah of course I have a boyfriend makes up these really cool stories and
لا المسيح طبعا عارف واثق من نفسه مش محتاج.
Christ is different. He's pretty sure of himself. And
وشايف القلوب بتاعت الناس.
And he sees right straight through their heart.
خلونا نكمل الآية.
Let's finish
فقال
this verse.
لهم أنتم الذين تبررون أنفسكم قدام الناس.
And so he said to them, "You are those who justify yourselves before men."
يعني مخدعين.
You guys are deceptive.
يعني كذابين.
You guys are liars.
اللي جوه قلبكم مش بره.
What's in your heart is not really what's outside.
انتوا بس بترضوا الناس عشان الناس يقولوا عليكم يا انتوا ممتازين بتاع الناس بتاع الدين يعني.
You just please people so people could be wild.
لكن
those are the religious
شوف الحته
people.
اللي بعديها كده.
Look at the next part.
معاك الكتب؟
You guys have your Bibles?
لوقا 16
Luke 16
وعدد 15
15
لو حد نام مني انا معايا
So, I have water that I'll squirt on people who are asleep.
حد يقول لي إيه اللي بعديها؟
What's after that?
15, 16, 15.
Luke 16:15. After he says, "Those who justify, you are those who justify yourselves before men." What does he say after that?
بالضبط كده لكن الله يعرف قلوبكم
exactly but God knows your hearts
ان المستعلي عند الناس هو رجس قدام الله
for what is highly esteemed among men is an abomination in the sight
of God ربنا يعرف القلوب
God the Lord knows the hearts
ربنا يعرف قلبي وقلبك
God knows my heart and your heart
كلامك ما يهمش كتير
your words don't really matter that much
لكن المهم القلب.
What really matters more is your heart.
صدقوني أنا ابتديت أحب الابن الضال.
I really started to love the prodigal son.
لأنه راجل أمين قوي يعني.
He's quite sincere.
وهو بيبعد عن ربنا. صريح.
When he went far from God, he was actually quite open and honest about it.
ولما يجي لربنا صريح برضه.
And when he comes back to God, he's quite honest and sincere about it.
مش بوشين.
He doesn't have two faces. He's not two-faced.
زي ما قال ربنا الوديع قال يا زوير رأيي يعني.
He doesn't have this two-minded thing.
لا.
Not at all.
لكن الابن الأكبر.
But the older son.
كان ليه رأيين وشكلين.
He had two thoughts and two faces.
كان جوه البيت شكله ابن.
Inside the house, he looked like a son who serves his father.
لكن قلبه كان بره.
But his heart was really outside.
عشان كده قال انت لم تعطيني مالا لافرح مع اصدقائي.
And that's why he said you did not give me a young goat that I may make merry with my friends.
يعني كل قلبه كان فين؟ كان برا.
So his heart was really where? Outside.
مع أنه كان جوا.
Yet he was physically inside.
يا رب ادينا ان احنا يكون قلبنا فعلا قدامك صافي طاهر.
Lord, help us that our heart is truly pure and honest before you.
اديني قلب يا رب حسب قلبك.
Give me a heart, Lord, according to your heart.
ما يكونش كلامي وصلاتي وترنيمي مجرد كلام، لكن تكون حقيقة جوه قلبي.
That my words, my speech, what I pray is not just a bunch of words, but it's the sincerity of the heart that's within.
واحد تاني جه لربنا، أنا بتكلمكوا عن تلاميذ المسيح كمان.
I'm going to talk with you even about disciples of Christ.
يعني بطرس.
Peter.
جه للمسيح وقال له إيه؟
He came to Christ. What did he say to him?
قال له أنا يعني مش هسيبك أبدا.
He says, listen, I'll never leave you.
ده يعني حتى لو كان للموت أنا معك.
Even to death, I'm with you.
شوف ربنا قال له إيه؟
Look what the Lord told him.
قال له الحق اللي في قلبه.
He told him exactly the truth of what was really in his heart.
في لوقا 22.
In Luke 22.
وعدد 33
verse 33
قال له يا رب ده بطرس.
So here Peter speaks, he says, but he said to him, Lord,
إني مستعدا أمضي معك حتى إلى السجن وإلى الموت.
Lord, I am ready to go with you both to prison and to death.
فقال المسيح قال له.
And so then Christ responds and he said,
أقول لك يا بطرس.
I tell you, Peter.
لا يصيح الديك اليوم.
The rooster shall not crow.
قبل أن تنكر ثلاث مرات أنك تعرفني.
This day before you will deny three times that you know me.
كان كلامه وصلاته يا رب بحبك.
His words and his prayer, Lord, I love you.
أموت عشانك.
I'll die for you.
أنا مش هسيبك.
I will not leave you.
وإحنا كتير في الترنيم المشاعر زي بطرس كده بتقول كتير.
And many times in the songs, the emotions, they like Peter says a lot.
أنا مش بقلل من الترانيم ولا المشاعر بتاعتنا في الترانيم، لكن يا رب خلي كلامنا يكون فعلا حقيقي.
I'm not belittling or lowering the songs and having emotions in the song, but I, what I'm saying is, Lord, let our words be sincere.
ومش بعد ما نتكلم ونقول الكلام ده نطلع وننكر المسيح.
And not like after we say these big things to Christ, we walk outside and deny Christ.
على فكرة ربنا مش هيسيبنا برضو، لأن احنا قلبنا برضو واحنا بنقول الكلام ربنا بيسمع.
And God's not going to leave us. He sees our heart and he hears.
عشان كده قال له طلبت من أجلك لكي لفنا إيمانك.
And that's why he said I prayed for you that your faith may not fail.
ولما أنكر بص له.
And when he denied, he looked at him and he restored his soul.
لكن نفسي أنا عايز أقوله لكم إن ساعات كلامنا ما يبقاش حقيقي.
But what I want to say is sometimes what we say is not sincere.
علشان كده من جوه المشكلة هي من جوه من قلبي أنا.
And that's why the core of the problem is inside.
سبب عدم وجوعي وقربي للمسيح مش هو في الناس ولا في الظروف، لكن هو في أنا، في رغباتي، في لذاتي.
The reason why I don't come back, it's not in people, it's in me and my desires.
لذاتي في الحاجات اللي مشغول بيها.
My desires and the things that preoccupy me.
زي ما قال الوديع التريجرز، الحاجات الكنز، كنزك هناك، كنزك يكون قلبك.
And like it's mentioned that where your treasure is, there your heart is also.
أنا مش عارف إيه التريجر بتاعك وإيه لذتك، لكن ممكن يكون حاجة سوشيال، يعني حاجة يعني في الميديا، سوشيال ميديا مثلا.
Well, I don't know what your pleasure is and where your treasure is. Maybe it's social media.
أو recognition، عايز تبقى يعني معروف من الناس أو من أصحابك.
Maybe you just desire fame or recognition to be known by people.
أو prestige ممكن.
Maybe prestige.
لا أنا ما أعرفش. كل واحد في لذة معينة.
Everyone has different desires.
لكن ربنا عارف الكل وشايف الكل.
But the Lord knows all and sees all.
رب عايز يشفي الحاجات دي علشان فعلا يكون قربنا لربنا قرب حقيقي.
The Lord wants to heal these things so that our nearness, our closeness and nearness to the Lord is true.
أنا نفسي أجيب مثل تاني قبل ما ندخل في لوقا. لوقا 9 متى 20 ولوقا 9.
Another example in Matthew 20 and Luke 9.
ناخذ متى 20 الاول.
Let's go to Matthew 20 first.
وبعد كده نروح للوقا 9.
And then we'll go to Luke 9.
في
في اثنين من التلاميذ واحد اسمه يوحنا وواحد اسمه يعقوب.
Two disciples, John and James.
هم ابني زبدي.
They are the sons of Zebedee.
فقوم للمسيح.
So they came to Christ.
فالمسيح قال لهم في عدد 21 فقال لها ماذا تريدين؟
And so he said to her about to their mother, what do you need? What do you wish?
فقالت له قل أن يجلس ابناي هذان واحد عن يمينك واحد عن يسارك.
She said to him, grant that these two sons of mine may sit one on your right hand and the other on the left.
إيه رأيك في السؤال ده؟
What do you think of her question?
واحد عايز يبقى عن يمين المسيح وعن شمال المسيح.
One wants to be on the right hand of Christ and the other on the left hand of Christ.
إيه رأيك يا بيبو؟
What do you think, Bibo?
حاجة حلوة مش كده طلب حلو.
Good or not? Yeah.
جميل. مين يقول لا؟
Who would say no?
مين عايز يبقى عن يمين المسيح وشمال المسيح؟
Who wants to be on the right-hand side of Christ and the left side of Christ?
كلنا طبعا.
We all do.
لكن المسيح عارف القلب مش كده؟
But Christ knows the heart, right?
ممكن نطلب حاجات لكن مش عارفين الثمن اللي يدفع علشان نوصل للطلب.
Sometimes we ask for big things not knowing the ramifications and the price that باركني. Needs to be paid to get this. Lord bless me.
تعرفش باركني دي معناها ايه؟
And sometimes people don't even know what that means. What the Lord bless me. What is that?
فاعرف اللي انت بتطلبه.
They don't even know what they're asking. You need to know what you even ask.
يعني وانت بتقول يا رب باركني او يعني هيبقى فيها ان انت لازم تسيب حاجات كتير مش كده؟
I mean, if you want the Lord to bless you, I mean, you gotta let go of a lot of things.
مستعد؟
Are you ready for that?
هل هتعمل كده؟
Will you do it?
ده فيها صليب.
There's a cross.
ده بعد شويه المسيح هيصلب.
I mean, soon after this, Christ got crucified.
مستعد ان انت تروح الصليب؟
Are you willing to go to the cross?
يبقى انت مش عارف انت ايه اللي بتطلبه.
Then you don't even know what you're asking for.
عشان كده قال لهم فاجاب يسوع.
And so that's why Jesus answered and said,
لستما تعلمان ما تطلبان. أصل ربنا عارف القلب.
You do not know what you ask. He knows the heart.
أتستطيعان أن تشربا الكأس التي سوف أشربها أنا وأن تصطبغا بالصبغة التي أصطبغ بها أنا؟
Are you able to drink the cup that I am about to drink and be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with?
ربنا شايف القلب.
The Lord sees the heart.
طب نروح للوقا 9.
Let's go to Luke 9.
ونشوف الأخين الحلوين دول.
And these two, let's see these two beloved brothers.
لوقا 9 عدد 51.
Luke 9 verse 51.
عدد 54.
Verse 54.
لما شافوا دخلوا قرية للسامرين حتى يعدوا له فلم يقبلوه ما قبلوش المسيح.
So they were going, and it looked like they were going to the city of the Samaritans, and
but
they did not accept Christ; they rejected him, and so.
فلم يقبلوه لأن وجهه كان متجها نحو أورشليم.
And they did not, accept him because his face was actually.
فلما رأى ذلك تلميذاه يعقوب ويوحنا.
His face was set toward journey to Jerusalem, and so when his disciples.
فلا يا رب أتريد أن تقول أن تنزل نار من السماء. فتفنيهم كما فعل إليا.
When his disciples James and John saw this, they said, "Lord, do you want us to command fire to come down from heaven and consume them just as Elijah did?"
ده قلبهم إيه ده؟
What's their heart?
قلبهم للناس البعاد عن ربنا يا رب أنت حل واحد بس إن أنت تنزل نار من السماء وتحرق الناس دي.
And so their solution to people who are far from God is bring fire.
دول اللي عايزين يقعدوا واحد عن يمين المسيح واحد عن شمال المسيح.
And these are the two guys who want to be one on the right hand and the left hand of Christ.
طلبتهم بس قلبهم ما فيهوش محبة.
But their heart doesn't have love.
في عايزين نار تنزل وتحرق الناس اللي ضد المسيح.
They want fire to come and get rid of these people that are against Christ.
فيهم روح الإدانة.
They have a spirit of judgment.
ما فيهاش روح الحب.
They don't have a spirit of love.
عشان كده التفت وانطهر التلميذين دول.
And so he turned and he rebuked them.
وقال لستما تعلما من أي روح أنتما.
And so he said, you do not know what manner of spirit you're
لأن
of.
لأن ابن الإنسان لم يأتي ليهلك الناس بل ليخلص.
For the Son of Man did not come to destroy men's lives but to save them.
يا جماعة احنا ساعات كتير بنقول حاجات بس احنا مش عارفين اللي احنا بنطلبه ايه.
Guys, many times we ask for things that we don't even understand what it is that we're asking.
وربنا عارف القلب.
And the Lord knows the heart.
وبيتعامل مع النفس.
And he deals with the soul.
علشان يوصلها للقرب منه الاتفاق مع المسيح.
To get that soul to be close to him, to have to be in.
عشان أبقى قريب من المسيح لازم أتفق معه.
To be close to him, I need to be in unity with him.
ما فيش واحد صديق تمشي معه.
There's no close friend that you can walk a journey with.
وانت يعني مختلف يعني ازاي تمشوا مع بعض وانتم مختلفين مع بعض
and you have difference in opinion how are you gonna make it through the journey
هتضربوا بعض وتموتوا بعض قبل ما توصلوا للحته اللي انت فيها
you'll hit each other and kill each other before you get to your destination
فمن فضلك ما تروحش معاه احسن
so just don't go with them in the first place
لازم الكتاب بيقول كده انه لو رايح طريق ومعاك صديق اتفق معاه الاول قبل ما توصل
the Bible says listen if you're going somewhere and you have a friend be in agreement before
واحنا بنقترب من المسيح المسيح بيقول اقتربوا الي
near to Christ says draw near to me
يعني اقتربوا الي يعني تمثلوا بي
meaning be in my likeness
اتفقوا مع روحي ورسالتي
Be in agreement and unite yourself with my spirit and my message.
تعال النهاردة وانت بتقول يا رب أنا هرجع لك يعني هقرب لك يعني يا رب أنا بقبل طريقك بقبل روحك بقبل خطتك.
Come today and say, Lord, I'm gonna come close to you. I accept your way. I accept your spirit. I accept your method.
ورب يشتغل معنا بقى.
And then the Lord
وأنا أقترب إليكم.
It works in us, and then it says, "And He will draw near."
ما تعلش الهم الباقي.
Don't worry about the rest.
اقبل وافرح برسالة المسيح ليك.
Accept and rejoice in the message of Christ for you.
وربنا هيشتغل في الباقي معك.
And the Lord will work on the rest with you.
والذي ابتدأ عمل صالح هو يستطيع أن يكمل.
And he who started a good work in you is able to finish.
مش منك.
Not in you.
لكن هو اللي هيكمل الطريق معاك.
But he's the one that's going to finish the journey with you.
بس احنا نتفق الأول.
But we just need to be
في عقد يتكتب ونمضي عليه. يا رب أنا موافق على العروض بتاعتك.
There's a contract that needs to be written and signed that we accept his conditions.
ووديع قال لنا على three do with three don'ts.
And we talked about three don'ts and three do's.
هل تتفق مع المسيح؟ هل تتفق على الحاجات دي؟
Do you accept and do you agree to these things?
في عقد انت اي حاجه في مشروع داخل في حاجه بيبقى في عقد بتمضي عليه تقول انا موافق.
And so any project that you go on you have to have a contract and you sign you to agree upon it on the terms of the contract.
رب منتظر مننا ان احنا نقول انا موافق يا رب.
And the Lord is waiting for us to sign and say we agree Lord.
وهو يقول لك انا هكمل.
And then he says, "I will finish."
أنا اللي هشتغل.
I will work.
لأن الله هو العامل فينا أن نريد وأن نعمل من أجل المصالح.
For he is the one, the God is the one who works in us to will and to do for his good pleasure. It's not really us.
لكن هو اللي هيعمل.
But he's the one that's going to do.
نفسي أختم بحاجة. في يعقوب نرجع تاني مرة تاني ليعقوب ثلاثة أو أربعة.
I want to end with something in James 4.
وهو بيقول من أين الحروب والخصومات.
When he says where do wars and fights come from.
في حرب جوايا.
There's a war inside of me.
وحرب مع الناس.
And there's war with people.
وحرب مع ربنا.
And there's war with God.
يبقى وديع بيقول ثلاثة وأنا هقول ثلاثة برضو بغير منه يعني.
So I'm gonna share three things too.
طيب التلاتة دول التلات أسباب المرض بتاعنا إيه هو؟
What are the three the three reasons of our disease?
أول حاجة حرب.
The first is that
مع نفسي مع رغباتي مع لذاتي.
I have war with myself. With my desires.
تاني حاجة حرب مع الناس لأن فاكر الناس هي تمنعني.
And so, and then the second thing is I have war with people because I think they're going to get in my way of what my desires.
وثالث حاجة حرب مع ربنا.
And the third thing is I have war with God.
تطلبون ولستم تأخذون لأنكم تطلبون رديا.
And so you ask and do not receive because you ask amiss.
وربنا عطانا الحل بعد كده في الوديعة قالها لنا من عدد أربعة لعدد عشرة.
And then you see the solution from verse 4 to verse 10.
كان بعد كده بقى.
And then after that.
بعد ما
تمتعنا بالحرية.
After we've experienced freedom,
يا ترى إيه المظاهر بقى إن إحنا فعلاً ماشيين مع ربنا واقتربنا لربنا.
How can we tell? What does that look like? What are the characteristics of someone who has been freed, has experienced this freedom of nearness to God?
هيتقال في الحتتين اللي بعد كده.
And that's found in the next two parts.
هيبان المظاهر بتاعته والثمار بتاعة علاقتي مع رب لو كانت هي حقيقية بختبرها بعلاقتي مع إخواتي.
And so if I have true nearness to God, I can measure it and test it by seeing how is my relationship with my brothers and sisters.
كل theory لازم تختبر عشان نعرف إن هي صح ولا لا.
Every theory has to be tested to be examined if it's correct or wrong.
أي medication بندي للناس لازم يحصل فيه اختبارات عشان نعرف إن ال medication ده هو كويس يعني.
Any medicine before it's released, it has to be tested to be proven that it does help.
And will FDA يعني approve it كده يعني.
Has to be FDA approved that it does what it claims to do.
ما فيش واحد يطلع بدواء لوحده كده ويقول ده ممتاز للكانسر مثلا كده.
You can't just have someone just make up something and say, "Oh, this medicine is great for cancer."
بدون ما يحصل له اختبار إن هو فعلاً ينفع للكانسر.
Unless they do medical trials to see that.
عشان كده لو أنت قلت إن أنا عندي قريب لربنا ولي علاقة مع ربنا لازم هذا يختبر.
And if you say it works for cancer, it has to be tested. And if you say you have a relationship with God, that has to be tested.
واخدين بالكم؟
Do you guys notice?
ما نقدرش نقول كلام أنا قريب من ربنا واشتغل على مزاجي واعمل تطلع ثمار وحشة يعني ما ينفعش.
I can't just claim that I am close to God and I'm near God and then I do things the fruit is far from God.
فالحتتين اللي بعد كده في الأصحاح عبارة عن اختبار العلاقة بتاعة ربنا علاقتي مع ربنا.
And the next two parts in this chapter basically is a test of my relationship with God.
عشان كده اول حاجه اختبار علاقتي مع ربنا هي ما هي علاقتي بالاخرين باخواتي.
And that's why the first thing about my relationship with God, to test my relationship with God is how is my relationship with my brothers and sisters.
لو انت عامل مشاكل مع كل الناس اللي معاك يعني وتقول انا علاقتي كويسه مع ربنا انا ما اعرفش ازاي يعني.
If you say that if you have problems with everybody and cause problems with everybody and you say you have a close relationship with God, I don't really see how that matches.
خلينا نقرا الاعداد مع بعض.
Let's read these verses together.
لا يذم بعضكم بعضا ايها الاخوه. اخوه انا مش بقول ناس بره بقول اخوه في الكنيسه.
Do not speak evil of one another, brethren. Not people outside, these are believers, brethren.
الذي يذم اخاه ويدين اخاه يذم الناموس ويدين الناموس.
He who speaks evil of a brother and judges his brother speaks evil of the law and judges the law.
وان كنت تدين الناموس فلست عاملا بالناموس بل ديانا له.
But if you judge the law, you are not a doer of the law, but a judge.
واحد هو واضع الناموس.
There is one lawgiver.
القادر أن يخلص ويهلك.
Who is able to save and to destroy.
فمن أنت يا من تدين غيرك.
Who are you to judge another?
إيه رأيكم في الاختبار ده؟
What do you think of this test?
اختبار حلو مش كده؟
It's a good test, right?
خلينا نعمل تيست كده لنفوسنا ما بلاش تعمل اختبار لحد تاني واخد بالك الاختبار ليا وليك.
Let's put just you not someone else under the test. So you examine yourself, don't put someone else under the test.
معنى ايه يعني يذم اخاه؟
What does that mean to speak evil of one another?
Gossiping. What do you mean by gossiping? يعني ممكن اتكلم انا او اجي لك واقول الوديع ده على فكره جميل قوي وحلو قوي كده يعني ده مش قصب يعني.
You know, I can come and say Heba is beautiful and she's awesome. That's not gossiping.
Okay. حلو قوي قصب يعني كلمه بناتي كده يعني.
I like the word. He's trying to clarify the meaning. So he's trying to get more.
خلينا قصب مع بعض كده يعني خلينا على نميمة يعني نميمة طيب ما كلام كبير أصلا ما عايز أفهم
These are big words I want to understand it was gossip
وديع قال ده جاي من أسيوط يعني داعيينه من أسيوط يعني مش بيفهم يعني لا اللي بتوع أسيوط أنا خايف في ناس هنا من أسيوط هيموتوني أحلى ناس طيب ماشي
Talking about
Okay.
اللي انت بتقوله دلوقتي على التقسيط يعني
بالظبط هو ده صح you got me يا جدع okay
you got me good job
لا يزم يعني انا شايف كده
here's how I see it do not speak evil
يعني انا اشوف واحد
I see somebody
في حاجات حلوة وفي حاجات وحشة مش كده؟
There's some good things and some bad things.
كلنا فينا حاجات حلوة وحاجات وحشة.
All of us we have some good things in us and some bad things.
اللي بيزم ده بيمسك في الحاجة الحلوة والحاجة الوحشة.
So the one who speaks evil, what are they? Which part of the person do they hold on to? The good or the bad?
Okay. فخلينا نتكلم مع بعض نتكلم عن مع بعض ونتكلم على بعض بالحاجات الحلوة اللي فينا.
So let's speak to each other and about each other. Just take the good. Hold on to that. Go for it.
لأنك أنت خاطئ لو أنت مسكت بس الجزء الضعيف في أخوك.
Because you're wrong when you hold on to that weak part of your brother.
حاجة تاني.
Second thing.
مين أكتر واحد يعرفك؟
Who knows you the most?
طبعاً.
Yes.
بس مين تاني؟
But who else? Yes, you're right. But who else?
الفريندز بالضبط أو friends ليه ممكن مش بابا وماما لا
sometimes it's not dad and mom actually
يعني مش بتقول اسرارك لبابا وماما
sometimes you don't tell your secrets to dad and mom
لكن تروح لاصحابك
but you tell your friends
تقعد تقول لهم بقى على كل حاجه كوره كده يعني
and you share everything inside
مش خايف
واخد you're not afraid you see the
الحاجات الحلوه والحاجات المصايب اللي بتعملها تقول على اصحابك
the good things you do and these disasters that you do you tell to your friends
فمين يعرف كل اسرارك
So who really knows all your secrets?
انتوا من اسيوط ولا ايه؟ اكتر حد يعرف اسرارك هو اخوك.
The most person who really knows your secrets is your brother.
ممكن اخوك بالجسد.
It could be your brother in the flesh.
أو جس أو أخوك في المسيح.
Or your brother in Christ.
أو حد صديقك بعيدك.
Or a friend.
من فضلكوا بعد كده تختلف مع ما إحنا الأصدقاء دي ممكن إيه النهاردة صديقك وبكرة عدوك كده يعني.
And you know the friends, you know today is your friend, tomorrow is your enemy.
ال friendship يعني المخلصة جدا 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 دي نادرة يعني إن هي تستمر طول العمر يعني.
And these very sincere life lasting friendships are actually very few and they're difficult.
يا ترى لما تتقطع العلاقة بينك وبين صديقك لسبب أو لآخر.
So let's say your relationship with your friend is cut off for one reason or the other.
كنز.
And you have this treasure.
عارف الكنز ده؟
You know what this treasure is?
عبارة عن أسرار أخوك أو أختك.
The secrets of your brother or sister.
انت اللي عارف ضعفاتهم
you know their weakness
فانت بقى عايز تحكي مع صاحبك الجديد
so now you want to talk to your new friend
فهتروح تقول لهم على ايه
well, so what do you tell them
do you know كده ده انا اللي عارف what do you know we get excited والبقى الموضوع والقعده تبقى excited كده جميله يعني واحنا لازم يبقى عندنا قعدات حلوه يعني ولا ايه
and then you have these meetings and you say do you know and it turns into a very juicy meeting together
واحنا مش دريانين ولا دريانين مش عارف يعني
and we sometimes are not aware of what we're doing
قصد او من غير قصد
and but sometimes we do whether for reason or not
نبدا نطلع اسرار الضعفات اللي محدش يعرفها اللي عرفها عن صاحبي
we start أو أخويا. We start bringing out these secrets that I know about my brother.
وممكن تكون صح.
And it may be correct.
ممكن تكون صح.
It may be correct.
لكن تيجي تقول لها لحد تاني ده عبارة عن نميمة أو ذم.
But when you take that and you say it to somebody else, that's called gossip.
ده لو أنت فاضي بقى.
You, if you've got a lot of time in your hand.
لو واحد مش قريب من ربنا.
And also if you're not
close to God.
Don't tell me you're close to God when you're talking evil about your
brother. مش فاضي ان انت تتكلم اولا هتحمل قلب ربنا اللي مش بيفضح
number one.
First of all, if you're close to God, you're going to have God's heart, and you're not going to have this heart of exposing people, because God doesn't expose people.
مش هيبقى قلبك زي يوحنا ويعقوب اللي قال يا رب ننزل نار وحرق الناس دي.
Your heart's not going to be like John and James saying, "Hey, bring fire to take these people down."
لكن كل من قرب لربنا ناخد قلب ربنا.
The closer, the more near we get to God, the more we get His heart. And we get God's love.
محبة التي تستر كثرة من الخطايا.
The love that says that it covers multitude of sin.
مش تفضح الخطايا.
Not expose sin.
محبة ربنا تستر الخطية.
God's love covers
لو
sin.
لو قلت إن أنا بحب ربنا وقريب من ربنا ورايح تفضح إخواتك، اعرف إن أنت بعيد خالص عن ربنا.
If you say you love God and you're near God and you're going to expose your brothers, you need to know you are very far from God.
مع ربنا ايه؟ هل انت قريب ولا بعيد؟
You need to test your relationship with God. Are you near or are you far?
مش كلام يا جماعة.
It's not a bunch of words.
يعقوب بيقول رسالة يعقوب بتقول اختبر الإيمان بتاعك، اختبر قربك من ربنا شكله
words.
ايه؟
The epistle of James says, listen, you need to test that faith that you want to, that you say you have.
طب ليه ذم اخواتي غلط؟
Well, why is it bad to talk bad about others? He tells us why.
الذي يذم اخاه ويدين اخاه يذم الناموس ويدين الناموس. Yeah.
He who speaks evil of a brother and judges his brother speaks evil of the law and judges the law.
ازاي الواحد لما انا بتكلم وبدين اخويا يبقى انا بدين الناموس؟
How is that if I speak evil about my brother, how am I judging the law?
حد معايا؟
Anyone with me?
ازاي؟
How does that make sense?
الناموس بيقول ايه؟
What does the law say?
تحب الرب إلهك من كل قلبك؟
Love the Lord your God from all your heart.
وصية تانية زي الأولى؟
The second one is like it.
تحب قريبك؟
Love your neighbor.
كنفس؟
As yourself.
أنت لما تفضح واحد وتدينه بتحبه؟
You expose someone and judge them. Do you love them? Your brother?
يبقى أنت بتعمل ايه؟
So what do you do?
بترفض الناموس.
You're actually rejecting the law.
واخد بالك واحنا بنعمل كده
and when we are doing this
احنا مش بس بندين لكن احنا بندين الناموس
we're not just judging that person we're actually judging the law
انا بقول الناموس ده غلط مش بوافق معاه
what I'm
بعمل
saying
ضده
is I actually disagree with the law and I think it's wrong and I do against it
عشان كده بيقول وان كنت تدين الناموس فلست عاملا بالناموس بل ديانا له
And that's why if you judge the law, you are not doing the law, but you're a judger. You're the one who judges the law.
حاجة تاني.
Another thing.
إن في واحد هو اللي حط الناموس.
That there's a one person who put the law in
مين
place.
حط الناموس؟
Who's the lawgiver?
مين حط الناموس؟ الله.
God, right?
مين اللي عطى الناموس لموسى؟
Who gave the law to Moses?
الله.
God.
طب اللي عطى الناموس واللي طلع الناموس هو الوحيد اللي يقدر يحكم بالناموس.
The lawgiver, the originator of the law, is the only one who can judge.
مش حد تاني.
No one else.
ما تقدرش انت الدين.
You can't judge them.
لأنك مش دي هي مسؤوليتك.
Because that's not your responsibility.
ولا ده هو حكمك لأن حكمك دايما هيطلع غلط.
And this is not your place.
ربنا هو عارف القلب.
Will always be wrong. God knows the heart.
أنت ما تعرفش كل القصة بتاعت الإنسان.
You don't really know the full story about them.
ما تعرفش قلب الإنسان.
You don't know their heart.
ممكن في النهاية البعيد قوي يبقى قريب والقريب يبقى بعيد.
It's very possible that at the end the one who's really far turns out to be very near and the one who's very near is very far.
فما تحكمش قبل الوقت.
So don't judge before the time.
ربنا بيدي فرص لكل الناس.
God gives chances to everybody.
لأن ربنا عادل.
Because God is just.
ربنا عارف بيعمل إيه.
God knows what He's doing.
ما تقعدش الدين لأنك أنت ما تعرفش ربنا يمكن بيدي فرصة لهذا الشخص ويمكن هيتوب ويبقى يمكن في الأول قبليك بكتير.
Don't judge because God maybe is giving this person a chance and this person may even surpass you spiritually.
ويمكن الخطية اللي بتدين بها أخوك.
And maybe that sin that you're actually judging your brother about.
يمكن أنت تقع فيها.
Maybe you fall in it.
لأنك أنت بالضبط ضعيف زيه.
Because you're weak just like they are.
عشان كده بيقول في الآخر فمن أنت يا من تدين غيرك.
That's why at the end of that part he says who are you to judge another.
يعني أنت حاطط نفسك في مركز مش بتاعك.
Because see you put yourself in a position that's not yours.
حاطط نفسك مكان ربنا.
You put yourself in God's place.
حد عايز يحط نفسه مكان ربنا.
But someone really put themselves in God's place.
عرفتوا لي؟
Now do you know why?
مش لازم نزم اخواتنا.
Now do you know why we should not speak evil about one another?
أول حاجة.
First.
ليه؟
Why?
Against the law. بالضبط.
Against the law.
واحنا لما against احنا بندين الناموس.
And then we're judging the law.
ومين اللي حاطط الناموس؟ مين اللي بيدين؟
And who's the lawgiver? Who's the judge?
ربنا. يبقى انت حاطط نفسك مكان ربنا.
So that means you put yourself in the place of God.
ربنا يساعدنا علشان قربنا لربنا يخلينا ناخد قلب ربنا.
May God help us that our nearness to God helps us
وما يكونش مجرد كلام بنقول يا رب احنا بنحبك.
And just words saying, Lord, we love you, we're close to you.
لكن لما يجي الاختبار الحقيقي لقربنا لربنا يطلع تطلع محبة تستر الخطايا.
But when the true test comes to examine our nearness to God, that we find love that covers many sins.
في غلاطية 5.
In Galatians 5.
ممكن نطلعها مع بعض.
We can open it together.
فرحنا قوي واحنا بنقول ان ربنا حررنا من حاجات كتير.
We were really happy when we were sharing that, you know, God freed us from many things.
لكن ربنا عايزنا نثبت في الحرية دي.
But God wants us to not just be freed but to continue in this freedom.
ولما يجي الاكزام لما يجي التست لقرب ربنا يطلع مظبوط قرب ربنا ده مظبوط.
And when it comes to the test of checking my nearness to God, it turns out to be true that I am truly near to God.
عارفين ان في ذهب كتير فلسي يعني مش حقيقي مش كده؟
You guys know that
فلسو. فلسو ماشي لا في أسيوط بيقولوا فلسي. No, مش قصدي.
You know there's a lot of false gold out there.
مالك بأسيوط هيمسك فيا يا ولد قلت لكم انا هروح في داهيه النهارده.
I told you I'm going to get in trouble for what I'm saying today.
مين اللي يقدر يحكم على الذهب دوا ان هو صح ولا حقيقي ولا مش حقيقي؟
If you have a piece of gold, who can really tell if it's real or fake, if it's false?
بالظبط. يحطه تحت ايه؟ فاير بالظبط. يعرف.
Exactly. And they put it under fire and it tells you. You can tell.
الإجزام هيجي ويختبر إيمانك ويختبر علاقتك وقربك بربنا.
The exam is going to come to test your faith and to test your true relationship with
نجاح.
God wants to see success
وقرب حقيقي
and true nearness
بعلاقتنا مع بعض
in our relationship with each other
وكلامنا على بعض
and how we speak about each other
وسترنا لبعض للخطايا والضعفات
and how we cover each other and protect each other.
اوعى تخلوا ان انا علاقتي مع ربنا حلوه فده يخليك ان انت تعمل اللي انت عايزه.
Don't think that oh because my relationship with God is good so I can do whatever I want.
في عدد 13 غلاطيا 5:13.
In Galatians 5:13.
فانما دعيتم للحريه ايها الاخوه.
For you brethren have been called to liberty.
غير انه لا تصيروا الحريه فرصه للجسد بل بالمحبه اخدموا بعضكم بعضا.
Only do not use liberty as an opportunity for the flesh. But through love, serve one another.
حاسب الجسد هيشتغل فيك برضو لسه أنت قاعد وفيك الطبيعة القديمة اللي ممكن تتحرك.
But watch out, you know, yes, you have this freedom, but the flesh is still there and wants to move.
عشان كده بالمحبة محبة المسيح.
And that's why with love, the love of Christ.
بقربك لربنا إن أنت تاخد محبته. هي دي الحاجة الوحيدة اللي ممكن تقدر بيها تحب أخوك.
By your nearness to Christ, you can receive his love, and that's the only way you can truly love your brother.
مش سيمينار هنعمله عشان نوريك إزاي تحب أخوك.
There's no seminar where we can tell you how you can love your brother.
مش هينفع.
It's just not gonna work.
هيبقى فالصو.
It's going to be a false seminar.
صدقوني.
I promise.
كل ده اللي بنشوفه في العالم communication skills كلها عبارة عن إيه مظاهر.
It's like the stuff we see, you know, taught about communication skills. It's just an outward look.
How to get into what you wanted to get into it. How to reach the other people for your desires في الحاجة اللي أنت تخدمك أنت مش تخدم أصحابك.
How do you get people to you know agree with you on what it is that you desire?
لكن قربنا لربنا يخلينا ناخد المحبة اللي بيها نخدم بعضنا بعضا.
But your closeness to God, you receive His love that helps us love one another.
نكمل الآية.
Let's finish the verse.
لأن كل الناموس في كلمة واحدة.
For all the law is fulfilled in one word.
تحب قريبك كنفسك.
You shall love your neighbor as yourself.
في واحد بينهش نفسه.
Does anyone beat up themselves?
إلا العيان نفسياً يعني.
Except someone with a psychiatric illness.
يجرح في نفسه.
Yeah, they wound themselves.
في واحدة صاحبتي.
I have a friend.
مش هقول اسمها.
I won't say her name.
ومش هقول القصة.
And I won't say the story.
وأنا آسف إن أنا ابتديت الموضوع.
And I'm sorry that I even started.
إنها على طول بصت لي.
Because she looked at me right away.
طيب. أوكي. فإن كنتم تهش فإن كنتم تنهشون في نهش.
But if you bite, so there's biting.
إذا في bite هنا. ده Nathan بقى ولا ده. كنتم تنهشون.
But if you bite.
صدقوني ممكن ده احنا بنعض بعضنا بشكل.
We bite each other in صح. ways. صح. It's really bad actually.
صح. لما نختلف مع حد.
Or when we have a difference in opinion.
نأكل بعض يا سلام.
We devour one another.
فانظروا لألا تفنوا بعضكم بعضا.
Beware lest you be consumed by one another.
ده الكنيسة.
That's the church.
ده اجتماع الشباب بتاعنا.
That could be our youth meeting.
ربنا عايز يطلعنا ان احنا نحبه.
God wants us to walk out of here loving him, be close to him.
فنعرف نتعامل مع بعض حلو.
And so we would know how to deal with each other in a good way.
ومحبته.
And his love.
تظهر في علاقتنا مع بعض.
Would show up in our relationship together.
وكلامنا على بعض.
And how we speak about each other.
احفظ الأسرار من فضلك.
Please keep the secrets safe.
احفظ ضعفات إخواتك.
Keep your brothers and sisters' weaknesses safe.
طلع الحاجات الحلوة عنهم شجعهم.
Talk about the good things and encourage them.
نما أقول اسلكوا بالروح فلا تكملوا شهوة الجسد.
I say then walk in the spirit and you shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh.
الجسد يشتهي ضد الروح.
For the flesh lusts against the spirit.
والروح ضد الجسد في حرب هتبقى.
And the spirit against the flesh is going to be warfare.
بعد ما تقبل علاقتك مع ربنا في حرب في الجسد بتاعك الطبيعة القديمة لسه ما زالت موجودة فيك.
After you accept and you have a relationship with God, then the old nature is still there and there's warfare.
ما تخافش.
Don't be afraid.
وما تنزعجش.
Don't be troubled.
لما تلاقي نفسك يعني الجسد ابتدى يشتغل فيك من جديد.
When you find that the flesh is starting to work again.
لكن الروح بروح القدس.
But the spirit by the Holy Spirit.
تقدر تهزم كل أعمال الجسد.
You can defeat all the works of the flesh.
وبقربك لربنا أكتر.
And by your more nearness to God.
ربنا هيديك نعمة أكتر.
God will give you more grace.
نعمة تغلب الجسد.
Grace to defeat the flesh.
لكن بعد كده بيقول وإذا انقضتم بالروح فلستم تحت الناموس.
And after that it says, but if you are led by the Spirit, you are not under the law.
وبتكلم عن أعمال الجسد طبعا معروفة.
The works of the flesh, which we know them.
لكن بيتكلم بعد كده ثمر الروح.
And then after that he speaks about the fruit of the Spirit.
عشان كده في عدد 25 إن كنا نعيش بالروح.
And that's why in verse 25, if we live in the Spirit,
فلنسلك أيضا بحسب الروح.
Let us also walk in the Spirit.
يا ترى احنا بنعيش بالروح.
Do we live by the Spirit?
يبقى هتطلع سلوك وكلمات حسب الروح.
Then the words and the walk will be according to the Spirit.
ويختم الموضوع.
And then he ends it.
بالمشكلة بالمرض.
With the problem, the disease.
اللي يعالجه حاجة واحدة بس.
That only one thing can treat.
قرب لربنا.
By being near God.
وعمل الروح القدس والنعمة اللي بيدهاني
and the work of the Holy Spirit and the grace that he gives me
يخليني دايما متضع قدامه
will make me always be humble before.
لنكن معجبين بنفسينا
let us not be conceited
نغاضب بعضنا بعضا
provoking one another
ونحسد بعضنا بعضا
envying one another
يا ترى أول تست أول اختبار لعلاقتنا وقربنا لربنا هل هننجح فيه؟
I wonder, will we pass the test that examines our nearness to God? Will we pass that test or not?
يبقى لسه احنا لسه عايزين نقرب أكتر
أمين نقرب أكثر.
Do we want to draw even closer to God?
عشان ننجح في علاقتنا مع بعض.
Amen. So that we can be successful in our relationship with each other.
أمين.
Amen.
لو ال worship team يجي ونختم مع بعض بالصلاة.
Have it all. I just pray, Lord, that you'd help us reflect on the message, Father God. That you'd help us reflect on you, Lord, and to put aside everything that's within our heart that's not pleasing to you, God. To put aside anything that's on our mind, God, that's not from you, Lord. And I just pray, God, that we would just sit before you and to truly ask you, God, to show us what you want us to do, to show us what do we need to work on in our hearts, God, to show us, God, how to treat one another, to show us how to seek you, to show us how to have faith in you, Lord, and so that we may be pleasing to you, Father God. Lord, I thank you, God, that you are so powerful and that you're so loving and you're so forgiving, Lord. Thank you, God, that you're so gentle on us, God. And I pray, God, that we would be so sensitive and so in tune with your spirit, God, that our convictions are so clear to us and so strong to us, God, that we are so quick to react to it, Father God. And Lord, I just pray at this time that we would come to you with our ugly hearts, God, and put at your feet to work in it, Father God, to work through it, Lord, to cleanse it, Father God. Lord, we want to know you, God, but we don't know how. We want to please you, God, but we don't know how. We want to have that strong relationship that everybody talks about, but we don't know how. And so, Father, I just pray that you provide these answers to us, Father God. And I pray, God, that just as was shared earlier, Lord, that we'd continue in this freedom, God. That we continue on pursuing it, Lord. That we'd continue on praying and reading your word, God. Acknowledging and realizing that Satan is not going to leave us alone. The world is not going to leave us alone. Our flesh is not going to leave us alone. But what matters is how willing are we to fight those things to get to you, Lord. If we can get in our groups and just pray together and just kind of share prayer requests, if you will, and see what God wants from you. Father, I just pray for this time that you'd be speaking to us, Father God. And as we just sing the last song and to just see God, and no matter how many times we mess up, God, your grace is still enough for us and you're still loving to us, Father God. Help us, God, to be a broken vessel for you, Lord. And as we pray in our groups and we sing that last song, knowing that in our hearts that God will use us as broken vessels.
الكتاب يقول بهذا يعرف الجميع أنكم تلاميذي إن كان لكم حب بعضكم لبعض.
The Bible says by this they will know that you are my disciples if you have love for one another.
لو عايزين فعلا يبقى لينا خدمة مؤثرة للناس برا.
If we want to have an effective ministry with others from outside.
لازم نحب بعضنا.
We need to love one another.
النهاردة ربنا عايز ناخد خطوة عملية النهاردة.
Today the Lord wants us to take a practical step.
واحنا بنرنم الترنيمة الأخيرة.
As we were singing this last song.
لو ربنا حط في قلبك لو كان في قلبك من جهة أخ أو أخت في حاجة اتكلمت على حد وهو ما يعرفش أو يعرف من فضلك روح النهاردة للشخص ده واعترف ليه.
And if the Lord has put you on your heart, if you've spoken bad about a brother or a sister, and whether they know or not, to go and confess
ربنا عايز يحررك.
God wants to free you of that.
أنت اللي هتاخد blessing لما تعمل كده.
You're the one that's going to receive the blessing when you do this.
أنت اللي هتاخد بركة وأنت بتروح تعتذر لأخوك.
You're the one that's going to receive the blessing when you go and apologize to your brother or sister. No one's going to know anything about it, just between you and your brother or sister. If there's anything between you and any of your brothers or sisters, please confess it and go to your brother or sister. God will bless you. And will bless the meeting and will bless you because of this. Let's be practical. Not words. And let's discuss and let's also apologize if there's something. And let's forgive each other.
غلط فيك سامحه.
If someone did something wrong to you, forgive them.